Sometimes in life, you have to take a chance, especially when you have a rare talent. The player we're going to be talking about in today's video, he most definitely took a chance, and it hasn't paid off just yet. The chance he took, it was high risk, high reward. Some of the decisions we make in our everyday lives, they're not so big and they don't really matter. On the other hand, some can impact your life forever. This guy had everything in the world going for him. He was the number one overall player in the country, 5-star recruit, had that swagger, the confidence, everything you could imagine. It's really mind-boggling as to why he would risk anything at all when everything was in his favor. You know what I'm talking about. It's a little easier to take chances when you have nothing to lose. On the flip side, this guy had everything to lose. They say money rules the world, and I would agree. It also makes people do outlandish and crazy things. In today's story and situation, money was the biggest influence on what this player did. He straight up sold his soul for a bag. There's no other way to put it. I don't really understand it, and you'll see what I'm talking about later in this video because he didn't even need to do it. There's a lot of questions and a lot of things we gotta talk about, but however, it leaves us with the main question today. What really happened to Quinn Ewers? What's good, y'all? Hope you're having a blessed day. Just want to drop by and say, hope you all have a great Thanksgiving. I just want to say I'm super thankful for all of you. Every time you sub and like, it means a lot. And if you're new to the channel, feel free to hit that subscribe button. And yeah, hope you guys enjoy the story. Let's continue on. Quinn Ewers, and yes, I am saying it correctly. I thought it was Ewers, but it is Ewers. His last name's not that important, and I'm gonna try my best not to say it a lot throughout this video. Let me give you a little background check on Quinn. He's 6'3", roughly 200 pounds, plays the quarterback position, and oh yeah, he's the number one player in his class, or he was. Quinn Ewers was originally in the class of 2022, therefore, that means he should be a senior at this current moment in high school. He played his high school football in Texas for South Lake Carroll High School. In his high school career leading up to his senior season, he already threw for 6,445 yards, 73 touchdowns to only 8 interceptions. If you had the opportunity to see this kid play in high school, you could clearly tell he was one of the best players in the country. I'm not gonna go as too far as you saying, oh yeah, he's definitely gonna be an NFL quarterback, because we've seen what happens with Spencer Rattler and Tate Martell. Despite all of that, it was obvious he was far ahead of his class. The big controversial scandal with him didn't happen up until right before his senior season, around 5 to 6 months ago. Around this same time, I'm sure some of you are familiar with the NIL deal that came out. If you're watching this video, you should know what the NIL is. If not, let me explain briefly. To make a long story short, NCAA athletes weren't allowed to make money off of their names, and now they are. They can do endorsement deals, sponsorships on their Instagrams, and sign autographs, and all that good stuff. However, where it gets controversial in this scenario, that was only for college athletes, not high school athletes. And Quinn was a high school athlete who had a lot of media attention, and he could be making millions of dollars off his name as a high school senior. It was already speculated and said he's going to make millions of dollars alone in his senior season off of brand deals and endorsement deals. He was happy about it, his family was excited, everyone around him was excited for the potential in making money, up until this happened. The head board of Texas emailed Quinn Ewers' family and told him he can't make money off of his name in high school. Before we move on, we gotta talk a little about it. It's not quite as simple as you think. I know exactly what some of you are sitting there thinking. Yo, it's fine. Why doesn't he play that one season and then he can make all that money when he gets to college? It's only 1 year. Trust me, it took me a while to understand this. It's easier to say no, and it's easier to answer questions when you're not in that situation. It's easy for me and you to say, oh, I'd pass up the $2 or $3 million when we're not looking at it. And for the people that are saying, oh, that's only 1 year, he can get all that money in the next year. You don't know what's going to happen. He could have a career-ending injury and never see that money again. It comes down to this. We could debate it all day, but turning down $2 to $3 million is risky itself. Then again, too, you have to take into account, you don't know if his mom and dad have been struggling their entire life. This is life-changing money. Speaking of his mom and dad, I was doing some research. I found out his mom is a fourth grade teacher, and his dad works in the oil and gas business, and they're well off. Quinn was asked about this and the money if they needed it. He said himself, quote unquote, we don't need the money, it's just the principle of it. I'm not 100% sure what he means by that. I'm about 80 to 90%. I think he's saying, you know, my family, we're okay, we're not struggling, but Who doesn't want $1 million? I think we'd all agree. Okay, back up to date. They had a tough decision to make. They could either A, stay in high school, make $0, or B, go to Ohio State early and be a millionaire. Once again, it's not as simple as you think because Quinn and his parents wanted him to stay in high school, but they also didn't want to pass up on all the deals. I'm actually impressed with how his parents handled it. You would think they'd be mad. They weren't. Here's what they had to say. I don't think we're here to fight them or question the UIL, but we hold a different opinion, and we think our opinion is valid. We didn't ask for this situation, but it's upon us. It's our reality. We don't want Quinn to be a, I'm not too sure what they try to say here, for everyone who comes behind him, but right now, we are guided by what's the best for Quinn. They wound up getting a lawyer, and even the lawyer said it's illegal for him to sign autographs and profit off of his name, and there's no way around it. After a couple of weeks and a couple of long months of thinking, here's what Quinn had to say about his decision. If I enroll at Ohio State, obviously I'll be able to make money off of the deals, and I feel like it'd be a big advantage of learning the playbook and getting comfortable with the campus and all my teammates. But if I stay and don't get paid, I may be able to win a state title. It's hard. It's also unfortunate a kid at that young of age had to be put in all this mess. Your high school years are some of the best times of your life, and you can never get that back. You gotta enjoy it to the fullest. The money, it's always gonna be there. You can make more money, but you can't make more high school memories. At the same time, I'm asking you guys, how do you turn down $1.5, $2, $3, $4 million at that young of an age? I mean, heck, when I was in high school, if I had 20 bucks, I thought I had some money. Imagine millions of dollars. I'm going to try to wrap this up and sum it real quick. To make a really long story short, they decided what was best for them was to skip his high school senior season and go to Ohio State early. He did arrive to Ohio State a little later than the other recruits who weren't in his class. So right off the bat, he was behind the eight ball, and nobody really thought he would play this season. I did see some people anticipating and hoping he would start by week 5 or 6, but that's implausible. Ryan Day, who's the head coach at Ohio State, even by the week 1 and 2, said he didn't know all of the playbook. I'm also 98% sure he didn't even travel with the team in their first game, and I'm not too sure if he traveled with them the second game. It didn't take long though. Even though he was a young guy at Ohio State and many of these endorsement companies knew he wasn't going to play right away, he signed his first deal in August. This deal, according to ESPN and many other sources, was up to $1.4 million, and this is only one of them. He has a couple others. He signed this deal with GT Sports Marketing, and it's going to be where he signs autographs over the next couple of years, and they get to sell them. When I'm currently making this video, it is said he has 3 deals. I've heard 4, but I know 3 for sure. If his other 2 deals are at least half of that, he's already got over $2 million in the bank. You gotta respect the hustle, you gotta respect him. He's cashing out on these deals, and he hasn't even played a down of foot. Actually, he did play last week. He's only played 2 or 3 snaps at Ohio State. But hold on, hold on, hold on. We got a problem, we got a red flag. Matt, what's the problem? What's going on? I'll tell you what the problem is. It isn't a what, it's a who. That who is CJ Stroud. Don't worry, they're not beefing, they're not in trouble, they're teammates, they're fine. It's something else. CJ Stroud is one of the best quarterbacks in the country, and he's only a freshman. He might win the Heisman. The key word in that statement I just told you is freshman. He can't go to the NFL. He's coming back next year. I'm surprised nobody else is talking about this or bringing it up. Do y'all really think Quinn Ewers is going to sit another season at Ohio State? That means it'd be 2 full years without him playing any football at all. And that's only if CJ doesn't declare for the draft after his sophomore season. He could come back for his junior and senior season. Some of you may be saying, yo, Matt, he can't declare to his junior year. CJ Stroud is a redshirt freshman, and if you're a redshirt sophomore, I believe you can declare for the NFL draft. You can correct me on that if I'm wrong. Right there, we're looking at minimum, Quinn Ewers is going to have to sit the bench for another season. That is, if he stays, and right now there's been some rumors that he might leave. I wouldn't even say it's rumors, it's just people being realistic. Why would he stay another year when he can go to a different college, ball out, and go to the NFL? I can't remember where I saw this. I don't even think it was a media outlet. I think it was a tweet or something on Instagram. The best fit for Quinn right now would be to go to Texas A&M, and I think that's a great and perfect matchup. Texas A&M has all the pieces except for a great quarterback to compete for a national championship or SEC championship like they want to. Texas A&M needs a great quarterback. Quinn Ewers is a great quarterback. I at least bare minimum think he's better than what they got right now. Also have to take into account that Quinn Ewers is from Texas. Texas A&M, Texas goes together. Call me crazy. I try to put myself in shoes like how I would think in those situations. I wouldn't sit another year at Ohio State. I'd go to a different school. Why not A&M? He's back at home. He likes Texas. He also wants to play for a great program, a great team. They're a great team in the best conference. Unless he's absolutely in love with Ryan Day, the offense, the team, I don't understand why he'd stay there. With all that being said, we can get into the juiciest part and my favorite part of this video. Did he make the right decision or the wrong decision? Yes, he got a couple of million dollars, but did it cost him hundreds of millions of dollars? Did leaving high school early hurt his chances of getting to the NFL and hurt everything else? It's debatable. I kind of look at it like this. If a football player in their junior season declare for the NFL draft early when they're not ready or not at their highest peak and they get drafted in the fourth round, yeah, you're making a couple of million dollars. But let's say you come back your senior season, you ball out, you get drafted in the first round, therefore you'd be making $30 to $40 million. It's a big difference. When you get drafted in the first round, you make $20 to $30 million. When you get drafted in the fourth or fifth round, you make $3 to $5 million. $3 to $5 million is life-changing. But $30 million is family and generational changing. Let me know what you think in the comment section. I would say right now I agree with his decision to leave high school early and take the money. And I'm on his side and hopefully everything plays out for the best. I'd also say him being at Ohio State doesn't appear to be the option I would go with. I'd look to transfer because of that quarterback room is stacked. Right now he's currently the third string quarterback, so he's not even the backup. Even when CJ Stroud leads, he's not in place to take his position. You can be the number one quarterback in the country, five star, win all these awards, but when you get to college, that means nothing. Everybody in college was a five star, four star, three star, and they was the best player on their high school team. Nobody cares about that. It's a clean slate when you get to the college level and the NFL level. Nobody cares. You gotta start over. I'm wishing Quinn Ewers the best of luck. Hope he continues to see a lot of success in his football career. Let me know your thoughts on this down below. But with all that being said, it's going to wrap up this video. Hope you guys enjoyed. Hope you guys learned something. If you're new to the channel, hit that subscribe button and leave a like for more. And as always, let's be great. I'm out, y'all. Peace.